हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू लर्निंग विद डॉक्टर शिवांगी। सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज रिसर्च डिजाइन इन केस ऑफ डिस्क्रिप्टिव एंड डायग्नोस्टिक रिसर्च स्टडीज। वेयर एज वी ऑलरेडी स्टडी अबाउट द रिसर्च डिजाइन इन केस ऑफ एक्सप्लोरेटरी रिसर्च स्टडी, सो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दिस टॉपिक इन दिस वीडियो। दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ रिसर्च डिजाइन ऑन डिफरेंट बेसिस ऑफ स्टडीज। दिस इज द सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ रिसर्च डिजाइन इन केस ऑफ पर्टिकुलर टाइप ऑफ स्टडी। So what is the descriptive and diagnostic research studies based research design? We will discuss about this in this video. So firstly, we have to understand about what is descriptive and diagnostic research studies. Descriptive research studies is based on description. In this research study, we generally use different types of statistical methods, techniques, different types of random sampling methods, probability sampling method in this type of research study. The applicability of this type of research study is very wide. So this is general purpose used research studies. So what is the research design in case of descriptive and diagnostic research study? We will discuss the main topic of this video. So what is the meaning of this type of research studies? Basically, descriptive research studies are those studies which are concerned with describing the features of a particular individual or of a group, whereas diagnostic research studies determine the frequency with which something occurs or its association with something else. So what is meaning of these type of research studies? Descriptive is description based, features based. It defines the features, characteristics of a particular object, individual, group, etc. Whereas diagnostic research studies used to determine the frequency with which something occurs or its association with something else. The studies concerning whether certain variables are associated are example of diagnostic research studies. Whereas the studies which are concerned with specific predictions, with narration of facts, characteristics, features concerning any individual, object, group, or any type of situation, all are related to descriptive type of research studies. These type of research studies, basically social research, comes under descriptive research category. So what is descriptive and diagnostic? Descriptive is based on features of particular object, event, individual, etc. Whereas diagnostic research studies determine frequency or something event, how much time it occurs or its association with other variables. Now we come to the next points of these type of research studies. From the point of view of research studies, the descriptive as well as diagnostic research studies share common requirements, and such we may group together these two types of research studies. In a descriptive as well as diagnostic research studies, the researcher must able to define clearly what he wants to measure and must find adequate methods for measuring it, and along with clear cut definition of population he wants to study. There's different population, different sample in the case of descriptive and diagnostic research studies, and all the methods are different in both the cases. What are the methods we use, we'll discuss in the next slides also. Since the aim is to obtain complete and accurate information in this said studies, the procedure to be used must be carefully planned. The research design must make enough provision for protection against biasness and must maximize reliability with due concern for economical completion of research study. Generally, in any type of research studies, there should be chances of error. So by maximizing reliability, error becomes down or low, and biasness is also down in this case of diagnostic or descriptive research studies. So it is a very important point or plus point of this type of research studies. These are the basic step of any research process. So we have to clarify all the points in both of the research studies. What are the points? Formulation of objective. It is the first step of any research process. what should have to study, why it is being made, what is the purpose, we would classify, specify before starting the research process. Designing the methods of data collection. In generally descriptive research studies, we use a set of particular structured questions, particular structured interviews in the case of descriptive research studies. Selecting the sample. Sample selection is also predefined in this case. Generally, we take probability sampling method. Probability sampling method in the case of descriptive research studies. Next is collecting the data. Data collection is done through structured questionnaires or structured interviews within a limited time period. It means where can the required data be found, with what time period should be collected the data. Next is processing and analyzing the data. After that, a researcher has to process and analyze the data based on different types of techniques of data analysis and find the result on the basis of these type of analysis and processing. So these are the basic steps of research process. It should be predefined in the case of descriptive as well as diagnostic research studies. It is a very rigid and not flexible design. So we have to predefine all the points in the research process. In the descriptive and diagnostic study, first step to specify the objective with sufficient precision to ensure that data collected are relevant. If it is not done carefully, the study may not provide the desired information. So it is very important to prepare or find the main objective of particular research process. Then we come to the question of selecting the methods by which the data are to be obtained. In other words, techniques for collecting the information must be devised. Basically, there are two types of methods, secondary and primary. So which method we have to select? It may be secondary or it may be primary, or which type of secondary or which type of primary method we should have to select in particular type of research study. It should be also predefined in the case of descriptive as well as diagnostic research studies. Several methods like observation, questionnaires, interviewing, examination of records are available for the purpose of researcher may use one or more of the methods. Examination of records comes under secondary data method, whereas observation, questionnaires and interviewing comes under primary data collection method. I think this is clear to all of you. Examination of record comes under secondary data method, and observation, questionnaires, interview comes under primary data collection method. We will discuss in the next videos about secondary and primary data collection methods in detail. In short, I will discuss here. So, while designing the data collection procedure, adequate safeguards against bias and unreliability must be ensured. Whichever method is selected, the question must be well examined, made unambiguous. Interviewers must be instructed not to express their own opinion. Observers must be trained so that they uniformly record a given item of behavior. Recording of data is also a very important task. So proper recording is also very important. So the observer must be trained. An interview is also interviewer should give their answer in a precise manner. It is always desirable to pre-test the data collection instrument. It is right or not, it is reliable or not, it is valid instrument or not. It should be done through various methods, for example, Cronbach-Alpha method. It is used to check the reliability of the research instrument. We will discuss about all these topics in the next videos. So stay tuned with me for these topics. And validity is checked through correlation, factor analysis, etc. So this should be checked by different methods so that we should select the right instrument for particular research process. In other words, we can say structured instruments are used in such studies. In most of the descriptive and diagnostic research studies, the researcher takes out the samples, then wishes to make statements about the population on the basis of sample analysis. More often, sample has to be designed. So this is the data collection instrument for this type of research studies. Here we may only mention that problem of designing samples should be tackled in such a fashion that samples may yield accurate information with a minimum amount of research effort, usually one or more forms of probability sampling, or what is often described as random sampling are used. Here, in the case of descriptive and diagnostic research studies, non-probability sampling or non-random sampling is not used because sample is defined and it is numerical based. So there is no chances of use of non-probability sampling or non-random sampling. Here we use only probability sampling or random sampling in the case of descriptive and diagnostic research studies design. To obtain data free from errors introduced by those responsible for collecting them. So data collection is also a very important task for any research process. It is necessary to supervise closely the staff of field workers as they collect and record information. Checks may be set up to ensure that the data collecting staff perform their duty honestly and without prejudices. So biases should be reduced in this case. As data are collected, they should be examined for completeness, comprehensibility, consistency and reliability. Consistency is also checked through Cronberg alpha method. How the data is consistent, how the data instrument, collection instrument which we are using is reliable or not, we will check in the reliability and consistency checking method. The data collected must be processed and analyzed. This includes steps like coding the interview, tabulation, replies, observations, performing the several statistical computations, making graphs, etc. and so on. To extend the possible, the processing and analyzing the procedure should be planned in detail before actual work is started. We should define all the steps before starting the research process in the step of research design, because research design is a blueprint for a particular research process. So it is very important to prepare a proper research design for any particular research process. This will prove economical in the sense that researcher may avoid unnecessary labor such as preparing tables for which he later finds he has no use, or on the other hand, redoing some tables because he failed to include relevant data. Coding should be done carefully to avoid error in coding. For this purpose, the reliability of coders need to be checked. All the instruments, all the experiments should be done carefully. All the tables should be prepared properly so that no data should be left out. Coding is also a very important task to reduce error in the data collection process, to preparing the data for testing the hypothesis, etc. and so on. Similarly, the accuracy of tabulation may be checked by having a sample of the table written. In case of mechanical tabulation of material, that is the collected data or information, must be entered on appropriate cards, which is usually done by punching holes corresponding to given code. The accuracy of punching is to be checked and ensured. Finally, the statistical computations are needed, and as such, averages, percentages, various coefficients, for example, correlation coefficient, regression coefficient, etc., must be worked out. Probability and sampling analysis may be also used for this purpose. The appropriate statistical operations, along with the use of appropriate test of significance, should be carried out to safeguard the drawing of conclusions concerning the study. There are different types of softwares also used for this purpose, for example, Excel, STAT, SPSS, and for checking reliability and consistency, we can use also AMOS for factor analysis. So these are the different softwares and methods for doing the statistical analysis for the data collected in the research process also. We'll discuss the next points also. Last of all comes the questions of reporting and findings. After analysis, we have to prepare the report of all the findings. This is the task of communicating the findings to others, and the researcher must do it in an efficient manner. A proper, asynchronized report making is very important for any researcher so that others can easily understand it. The layout of report needs to be well planned so that all the things relating to research study may be well presented in simple and effective style. Thus, the research design in case of descriptive and diagnostic studies is a comparative design, throwing light on all points narrated above and the resources available. However, it must ensure the minimization of bias and maximization of reliability of the evidence collected. The SAD design can be appropriately referred to as survey design, since it takes into account all the steps involved in a survey concerning a phenomena to be studied. So this is all about the research studies, which is based on descriptive as well as diagnostic research studies. I again summarize all the points one by one so that you can easily understand all the points. Basically, descriptive is based on features of particular individual, situation, groups, event, etc. Whereas diagnostic is based on frequency of something occurs, how much time an event occurs, or its association or relation with some other variables also. So all the researches which are related to variables comes under diagnostic research studies, and all the researches which comes under finding facts and features concerning individual group of situations comes under descriptive research studies. Both research studies share some common points also. For example, data collection method, populations collection, defining population. A researcher has a big task to minimize error in all the cases, reduce biasness and maximize reliability in all the cases. So the result which we find after research process should be right and complete. These are the basic steps in research process which the researcher should have follow in any research process. First one is formulating the objective of study. Second is designing the methods of data collection. Third is selecting the sample. Fourth is collecting the data. Fifth is processing and analyzing the data. And last is reporting the findings. So all the points should be clear and predefined in the case of descriptive studies as well as diagnostic research studies. How to do all the processes? Firstly, a researcher has to define the objective of descriptive research studies carefully so that it provides all the desired information related to research process. Then he or she had to select the questions of methods. What are the research problem? It should also clearly define. Then we have to select the data collection method by which we have to collect the data. It should be secondary or primary. For example, in the case of secondary, examination of records. But in the case of primary, we can use observations, questionnaires, interviews, etc. And in the data collection procedure, all the testing should be done carefully and it should reduce biasness, and the unreliable data must be removed. Interviewers should give answer in a precise manner. Observers are also be trained, and the researcher should done a pretest for validity of data, so that we can say that structured instruments are used for this purpose. And in the next step, error should be minimized by doing reliability test, consistency test, completeness test, and comprehensibility test by the staff of researcher and helper of researchers. In the next step, we have to analyze and process the data by tabulation, computation, coding, and encoding, and applying different types of test for analyzing the result. After testing, we have to prepare the report of findings so that other one can easily understand the research process or conclusion of the result. So it is a very important type of research study to do properly a descriptive and diagnostic type of research studies. So this is all about the research design in case of descriptive and diagnostic research studies. If you have any query about this topic or any other topic, you can ask me through comment box. You can contact me. If you like my video, please like and share this video and support me by subscribing my channel Learning with Dr. Shivangi. We'll meet in the next video with next topic. Thank you everyone.